You just took on a bookkeeping client and you realize that their books are a big commingling mess. There are tons of personal and business transactions on the books. What do you do? Hi, I'm Veronica Wasek, and I help virtual bookkeepers to become confident professionals and business owners. Let's go over some important tips and best practices when taking on a messy commingling cleanup in QuickBooks Online. Let's start with the different types of commingling. So what is commingling? It's paying for business expenses with personal funds, paying for personal expenses with business funds, tracking personal bank and credit card accounts in QuickBooks Online, connecting a personal credit card with a balance or a carry forward balance to QuickBooks, pocketing cash, and attempting to budget business and personal income and expenses in QuickBooks. Now let's go over some best practices when working with commingling clients. There should be no personal expenses included in the business books. Personal accounts should not be connected to the QBO bank feeds. For sole proprietors in the US, record any personal expenses to owner's draw or an equivalent account. For S Corp and partnership businesses in the US, business owners may be reimbursed for business expenses that were paid for with personal funds. Make sure to implement processes and accountability with your client to track cash expenditures. Next, let's go over some tips for working with a commingling cleanup. You'll need to identify and assess the bank and credit card accounts. Make a list of all of the bank and credit card accounts being used by your client. Ask your client whether the accounts are business or personal accounts. In some cases, clients use a personal credit card only for business, and that's okay, as long as they're using it only for business. Look at the bank and credit card statements and verify the name on the accounts. Sometimes clients think that they're using an account for business, but it's really a personal account. Here are some additional tips. The client is responsible for identifying business and personal transactions. That's up to the client. It is not up to you to determine whether expenses are business or personal. Avoid connecting any personal accounts to the QBO bank feeds. Remove personal accounts from the bank feeds. What if your client has personal expenses paid for with business funds? Record any personal expenses to owner's draw or an equivalent account. Your client may have also paid for business expenses with personal funds. In that case, ask the client to provide a spreadsheet or a listing of all business expenses that were paid for with personal funds. And then you'll need to record a journal entry by month. You'll need to debit all of the various expense accounts and credit owner's contribution or an equivalent account. What if your client connected their personal bank and credit card accounts to the QBO bank feeds? It's best to undo transactions in the bank feed and disconnect the bank feed. And finally, here are some very valuable lessons that I have learned along the way in dealing with clients who commingle. Avoid working with clients who refuse to stop commingling. You're incurring potential liability by working with clients who are commingling, especially if you're the one who's determining whether transactions are business or personal. It really makes for messy bookkeeping that is a lot more time consuming. And the client is not complying with your way of doing business. And it's hard to implement processes and accountability. So ultimately, it's very hard to establish boundaries with clients who are commingling. So your goal should be to not work with clients who commingle. But many of them are commingling just because they don't know any better. So you're the perfect person to help them to stop commingling. Have you come across a big commingling cleanup? Let me know in the comments. I'm Veronica Wasek. If this content is helping you, then subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and give me a thumbs up. And check the description below for all of my free resources, including my free Virtual Bookkeeper's Toolbox and the link to join my Facebook community. I'll see you next time.